recovery from it. But the message to the team is that we faced adversity before, and here it is again, staring us right in the eyes. And you know, this is an opportunity that we can take advantage of.
And how was Zeke? How is Zeke? How do you kind of?
Well, I mean, he's upset. You know, disappointed. So no way around it. It was tough news. So like I said, we're all just rallying around him and gonna support him as best we can.
How sure. tough is it that he made tremendous progress this year since December for this to happen in this spot? I guess in that context.
I think that's what makes it tough is, you know, we could see Zion continuing to improve this season, his progression, his impact on his team, our ability to have an opportunity to have a deep playoff postseason run. And so he was, you know, that makes it even more difficult when you've been trying to do the right things and you still kind of have a injury that sets you back.
And then with Brandon, you know, 2 games back after that long absence, how did he just, you know, respond coming off of Tuesday's game and everything?
He had a great practice today. He came in early tomorrow to get some work in. You know, he's knocking off some rust. He's been out for 4 weeks or so, and but he looked great today. He was playing with force, had a really good practice, sharp, and we look forward for him getting back on the floor tomorrow and getting after it.
You guys have after, you know, he doesn't play the last time, is you have to have a conversation, or is it just like – this happens, or how do you handle
it? No, there's some, definitely some discussions going on, and I'll keep those private, but for sure, we talk about it.
How much confidence do you have in this group? This will be the third straight year you're in this situation with pretty much the same group. How much confidence do you have?
I have a ton of confidence in this group. We've been in this scenario before. We've been in these types of games before, so they're well aware of what's ahead of us, and you know, we know we've beat Sacramento 5 times, but this is different. This game, this 6th game, is going to be the hardest. So we're expecting it.
Sorry. In situations like this, how much do you rely on Brandon, the facilitator, as well as Brandon?
You're going to need both. He's going to need to be a facilitator, scorer, rebounder, defender, and be him. And that's what we're expecting from all of our guys, the best version of themselves.
Just in general, when you have to make those tough decisions about guys in their minutes, how do you go about kind of handling those conversations, understanding, you know, guys are competitive, they want to help the team, but also, you know, making them understand where you're coming from when you make those decisions?
I mean, it's both myself and B.I. having a discussion and just talking it out and going from there. But those aren't easy decisions to make, but I'm in a position because I have to make them sometimes, and when you do, it's not about me being right. It's what's effective, and can we be effective on the floor? And you go back and watch that group was effective, and they gave us a chance to win the game.
Jose had 4 different things taped up before that game. It looked like he took a lot of blows. Is he okay?
He went through a full practice. He's fine. Yeah.
And when kind of something like this particular Z injury happens, and you know, a lot of the talk is, man, once again, this stuff always happens to the Pelicans. How you kind of avoid that feeling like, oh, here we go again, or you know, kind of that just feeling like the world's falling down on you?
It's a mentality, you know. You got to deal with it, be honest about the fact that this is where we are, and then we get a choice. That's what I told our group. We can look at this as an obstacle or an opportunity, and we're all here because we've had to go through adversity. We had to endure it. It tests your character. It tests your faith. But we're all here because we looked at it as an opportunity. We take advantage of it. And this is no different.
And how much do you think this one game sort of defines this season? I mean, if you win, people are kind of optimistic. But if you don't win, it's kind of...
That's up to people to judge and determine what they want to. I try not to focus on what everybody else thinks, but... just focus on what we can control, and we can be prepared. We can go out and play to our best, which is our goal, and then let the chips fall where they may.
You've unfortunately not had Zion from live a game since you got here. Do you feel like that can, that experience that you guys have had, especially I'm thinking 2 years ago when B.I. was and CJ were leading the team both in the play-in and then against the Suns in the playoffs, do you think that kind of experience and maybe whatever strategy you guys used back then can help you moving forward?
For sure. All of these experiences are meant to make us better, and they're learning experiences. So we're going to continue to grow, continue to get better. But, yeah, we lean on all of those experiences to help us now. I'm not sure. I'm not sure why we've been so successful against the Kings, but, you know, right now we have to block that out. Yes, we'll watch some tape on them, and we have a recipe of what we believe allowed us to be successful, but this is going to be a different game, and we have to embrace that. And like I told our guys, I'm extremely excited about the opportunity that we've given ourselves. We got two cracks at it, and this is it. So this should be exciting.
What do you think this particular team has been so good at bouncing back after adverse moments throughout the season?
Just a resilient bunch of guys, high character. They're consistent. They come in every day, and they put their work in. And we try not to let one game, you know, just continue to manifest into a whole season. It's one game. You win it, you lose it. Let's watch the tape. Let's come back to practice, and let's be consistent in our approach.
What's kind of stood out to you about the Kings, especially in their win over the Warriors?
They were physical in that game. They tried to make sure they took the ball out of Curry's hands, tried to make other guys beat them. But they played fast, and they played physical.
That was the only reason why I was in.
I didn't know who it was. I just heard full prices. I was like, all right, who's in? I have pissed people.
last summer and I fired off like a couple of
trying to give you a break. We were trying to give you a break.
Yeah.
Yeah, don't look at us. It's
no, I'm not blaming you guys at all. I'm blaming these
right
two. Well,
blame Big H. Blame Henry. He's the one to blame.
It's ridiculous. It's ridiculous.
Larry, I'm getting a little bit closer to that mic, but
we appreciate you, Larry.
Step on up.
So, just what was the reaction when you guys heard the news about Zion, him not being around, and just what were the conversations amongst you guys?
I don't care about anything but him. To a certain extent, it's like screw the team in this moment. It's a shame for him, truly. Like, he had an unbelievable year, and just because this happened at this time doesn't make it not a success. It was a success. My man was healthy. Played 70-some games. He was awesome. And hopefully we get to see him again this year. But your heart just hurts for him. All of us just hurt for him, and you feel for him. And it's unfortunate. But back to the team. All we can do is soldier on forward.
Have you had a chance to talk to him yet?
Yeah.
Hey, guys, how did that conversation kind of go?
Words of encouragement. He always knows if he needs a shoulder, needs a pair of ears to listen to him. I'm always there for him, your heart just hurts for him. Spent that moment in time is a really tough one to stomach for all of us, but for him especially. You just hurt for him.
Now you have a team that you beat five times in a row. So how do you go in not overly confident because of that and approach it the right way?
I think there's a difference between confidence and cockiness. We're going to go into it confident because we deserve to, and we've earned the right to go in feeling confident. But we ain't going in cocky. We recognize where we're at. We just lost two to the Lakers on our home court, and beating a team, I don't know if it's ever been done beating a team six times outside of the playoffs. So it's something that we know is not going to be easy, a walk in the park, but, we're confident, not cocky.
What have you kind of seen from the Kings recently, especially in that win over the Warriors?
Just the way their pace of play is just so rapid. I mean, Obviously, Fox does that by himself, generates all that pace. But the way Keegan Murray's been playing has been off the, both him and Sabonis' gravity has been great. Keon Ellis has stepped up huge. It's hard. You know, you miss a guy like Kevin Herter or a guy like Malik Monk, and Keon Ellis can step in and play that role to a T is really impressive. So they're playing really well. They're playing hot, and you know, this, like I said, this is not going to be like the first five matchups. It's going to be that much more intense and that much harder.
Yeah, why have y'all been so good against them in a way?
There are some teams that just match up better against others, and you know, respectfully, I feel like we match up well against them in terms of just the guys. You know, Herb is an all-world defender, and the past few games he's made De'Aaron's life pretty difficult, and both, you know, JV, you know, that's like playing against his little brother. You know, he's not in a disrespectful way, but just they're both Lithuanian. You know, they know each other's moves like the back of their hand. You know, it's always a good fight, good battle, and I just personally, I just like the way our guys guard them.
You guys have had the unfortunate experience of not having Zion for a lot of games the last 3 years. Can you rely maybe on any of those experiences, especially 2 years ago when you guys went to the play-in tournament, won two games, and gave the Suns a run for their money? Like, you feel like there's chemistry and strategies kind of in place almost for this scenario?
Yeah, I mean, you can't say we haven't been there before. You know, we know what it's like, and obviously we'd rather have them. That goes without needing to say. But you know, we've done it before. We've won big games without them, and we're a really good team, regardless of that fact. So you know, we need big games from a few guys to step up, and could come from anywhere. Could come from BI. Could come from Trey. Could come from Jose. Could come from Dyson, myself. Like, you know, you never know. So. You know, it's just next man up mentality, and we're going to be ready to go.
And I guess how would you respond to someone who would say if they don't win this game, the season was a failure, they failed to live up to expectations? I guess how would you feel about that type of sentiment?
I don't got anything to say to that. I mean, I really don't, because I don't care if again, tomorrow we plan on winning, we want to win, and that's the mentality going forward. If we don't, say it. It's not going to affect me at all. It's not going to affect us at all. We're, you know, we like our group. Adversity just happened to hit at a really unfortunate time. But again, I'm not planning on having to hear any of that because we want to win.
Not let, I guess, you know, the disappointment of what happened Tuesday, I guess, mentally carry over to Friday. Is that a challenge at all?
Yeah, I mean, it was really good to get yesterday to mentally reset, and then today to, you know, move on to the next one. Obviously, you know, that one did hurt, and it hurt that night, and it hurt all day yesterday. But, you know, stepping into the gym this morning, seeing everybody, and knowing that we got a refocused mindset and energy towards this next game is all we can do.
How important is kind of B.I. getting back into the floor for this game and making an impact for y'all?
Nah, B's going to be huge for us. He's going to be awesome. We've seen it time and time again. B.I., you know, steps up in big games, and you know, this is no different than any of those. He's a superstar, and he's going to show us tomorrow.
Thank you, Larry.
Yeah, but then y'all like swarm and like they're back here, so it doesn't sound like that.
Can you just take a step up?
What was the reaction when you heard the news about Z, and just, you know, how's that gonna affect you guys?
I mean, it's tough, you know. That's one of our best players going, being out for the most important games of the season. But, you know, we got his back, I mean, mentally, as a person, because I can only imagine how he feels as, you know, a competitive, as a young person that's trying to, you know, play in these games and obviously can't because he physically. So, you know, it would suck, but, you know, we with him, we with him through the whole thing, and, you know, he's with us, and we just got to take care of business so he can come back.
And what's the key to kind of making sure the feeling over not having him affects y'all tomorrow night?
I mean, like I said, it sucks not having him, right? But we did it before. I, you know, we've been there before, and of course we want him there. Obviously, that's we're way better when he's there. But we did some good things when, you know, when this happened before. So we just got to focus on that and focus on how we could continue the season and make sure he come back.
How are you feeling physically?
I'm here, you know. like, there's no complaints. You know, I'm going to put that jersey on tomorrow and give it all I got. So that's what it is. And I'm excited. You know, it's a big game, and I'm excited for it. I mean, that's a good question. We got to watch film, keep getting better. We did it 5 times. So whatever we did 5 times, we got to do it 5 times more tomorrow. So we know what they coming in as, trying to beat us. I know they tired of that beating us, but we can't get tired of beating them. So we gotta go over there and fight, cause it's gonna be a dog fight.
What did you just think about, I guess, the strides, the progress Zion made as a player in the last 4 months or so?
I mean, he improved. He listened to all the noise, to all the BS that was coming his way, and he, you know, he took it full speed and and he ain't never looked back. And obviously, unfortunately, you know, body didn't hold up as well. That's uncontrollable. He controlled the things that he could have, and, you know, he could be back, and he'd be better.
And you talked after the game about B.I. just being a competitor, and obviously he wants to be out there. What have you seen just the way he's kind of responded the past few days and want to make an impact in that game tomorrow?
He's ready. I think he's going to do what he do, and if we win that game, it's going to be because of him. And we believe that. I think he believed that. And he's going to do all the right things for us.
Thank you.
No, they're waiting.
Yeah, get out there. I don't want to be that bad, but I'm sure.
I was happy. I was like,